Hi everyone, welcome to investbankerproperty.com video blog. And today's topic that we're going to talk about, a lot of people like to ask us this question as well. So there are so many units in a development, so how do I go about selecting a good unit?
One of the things that we tell our clients is that always try to buy the highest floor possible. So if the development example is 20 levels, you try to buy level 20. So if level 20 is the penthouse and you don't want to buy the penthouse, then you try to buy level 19. So the one of the main reasons is that in future when you resell it, if you're, let's say hypothetically you bought level 10, then your level 10 unit you're asking for a price which is higher than maybe a unit that is selling on level 12. Then your unit will be deemed overpriced. Yeah, so normally we ask clients to buy the highest level is because then when you are reselling, you are asking for the highest price, right? It's easier to justify. Normally for like clients, international clients, a lot of them, they like to look for the highest floor. And when you want to rent out the unit, right? A lot of people, a lot of tenants, a lot of good tenants, they are also looking for very high floors. So if you bought your units on the highest floor, then there's almost no comparison. So always try to buy as high a level as possible. Then next, right, is that you have to take note of certain unit numbers. Chinese are superstitious, not all of them, some of them are superstitious. So we have clients from China, Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, they are Chinese, then they do ask us to look for units without the number 4 in them. So if you're purchasing, right, you try to do the same because it may be a little bit more difficult to sell if you choose a unit with the wrong unit number. And in Bangkok, right, try not to choose the 13th floor. In a lot of developments, they are usually labeled as level 12A. This level is actually level 13. It's considered an unlucky number in Bangkok, so try not to buy level 13. Okay, and try to buy units that are right at the corner. Not right at the corner or next to corner, near to the corner. Yeah, these are more private, and if you want to rent out, right, tenants tend to want to stay near the corner. It just helps to make it a little bit easier to rent out your unit. And of course, try to buy a unit which is far away from the lift or the rubbish chute. The rubbish chute is the worst. So try not to buy a unit whereby the lift opens and then that is your unit. Basically it's noisy and there's less privacy. Yeah, and if you have any unique features of the development, like recently we had a client who was asking us, should he purchase a unit with a bay window or without a bay window? We advise him to buy the unit with a bay window. So in Bangkok, right, the bay window is not like there's a ledge, then you can't stand there. So the bay window is a place where you can stand, then you have panoramic views of what's in front of you. You can look front, look left, and look right. It's just an extra 1 square meter space. So that's a unique feature, and it helps to differentiate your unit from other units if you are renting out. We had other developments whereby they had extra loft area, and maybe it was just marginally more expensive. So we advise our clients to buy these units, and eventually it was easier to rent these units out as well because there's a differentiating factor. Yeah, but in honesty, when you get your keys, right, you should spend some time and effort to differentiate your unit. Your unit will come, most of the time will come fully furnished, fully fitted, so you literally can move your luggage in or your tenant can move the luggage in straight away. But Bangkok is not very expensive when it comes to home furnishing. You can just go to the weekend market or any of the night market and do some small little furnishing, put some plants, put some paintings or anything to differentiate your unit so that it's easier to rent out. So this is the advice that we give our clients on how to select a good unit.
Yeah, so if you are looking to buy any property in Bangkok, you can always look for us.
Yeah.
We should be able to share with you what kind of units are worthwhile considering and so on and so forth. So you can actually email us or text us or just look for us. We should be able to help you.
Yeah, we get clients like emailing us like different floor plans and layouts and ask us whether which ones are better. Then we go through a discussion process. Then they can decide better.
Yeah.
So yeah, just anything, just email or message or WhatsApp us.
Okay. Yeah, that's all for now. See you at the next video. Thank you.